Reyna, help me out here.
What's wrong, Ashton? You sound miserable.
These guys want me to buy this antique helm. I told them no, but they won't stop pestering me about it.
What did they say?
They said it'd be a really good item for all three of us.
So how much does the helm cost, anyway?
Take a look.
I guess we could afford that. Okay, let's buy it.
Huh? Are you sure?
Well, why not? It's our fault in the first place that you have to deal with them all the time, isn't it? Besides, we're always buying all kinds of new things for ourselves. I think Creepy and Weepy deserve a little present every now and then, too.
Creepy really appreciates it. He says he's really touched by your gesture.
Oh, that's all right, Creepy. We're friends, right?
We can handle this.
Here goes.
I'll need to do my best!
This is pretty nice, don't you think?
It is, but don't you think this color would look even better on you, Celine?
Oh? Then how about this one?
Yeah, I like that.
What are you two looking at?
Ah, Reyna.
We're looking at jewelry, of course. Salva's a mining town, so there's a lot to choose from.
The handiwork isn't quite as good as the stuff you find in Cross, though.
Were you expecting otherwise?
Wow, you two really like jewelry, it seems.
Don't you, Reyna?
Oh, I'm sure she does. She's a lady, after all.
Yeah, I like them too.
Huh. You know, I bet a sapphire would look good on you, Reyna. It'd match your hair and everything.
What about an emerald? That's the birthstone for May, you know.
You can never go wrong with a diamond either. That would go pretty well with your complexion.
Why don't you pick out a stone you like? I have a little bit of spare change, so I'll buy one for you as a present.
Wait, what? Oh no, I really shouldn't.
Oh, don't worry yourself over it. Think of it as a gift from your big sister.
Thank you. Well, emerald is my birthstone.
The emerald it is.
Yeah, everyone should have at least one piece of jewelry with their birthstone.
Excuse me, I'll take this one. Ah, the emerald. Thank you very much.
Are you sure this is all right?
Oh, don't let it bother you.
Hey, Celine, how about me?
Nice try.
I picked up this handkerchief earlier. I think this is the house it belongs to. Excuse me, is this your handkerchief?
Oh, yes, it is. I thought I lost it. You look weird, but thanks a lot. My name is Eleanor.
My name is Ashton. Don't lose it again, okay?
Okay.
See you around.
Hey, Ashton? You're a traveler, aren't you?
Yep, that's right.
Is it fun?
Huh. Well, that's kind of hard to say. There's a lot of fun stuff, but it's definitely no picnic. In fact, I wouldn't be looking like this if it weren't for all the traveling I've done. Why do you ask, though?
I've been sick ever since I was born. I haven't seen anything except for what's outside the window. So I thought, you know, if I can't see the world for myself, then maybe I could hear all about it from lots of different people.
Oh, I see.
So I wanted to ask you, can you tell me about what the outside world is like?
Sure. I'd be happy to tell you everything I know.
Really? Thanks a lot, mister.
Oh, Reyna! I'm glad I ran into you. I was just about to go look for you.
I overheard the whole conversation. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to eavesdrop on you.
Listen, Reyna, do you think you could cure Eleanor's sickness? I mean, not being able to leave your bed your entire life, that's just sad.
All right, I'll give it a try. What are you doing?
It's all right. Don't worry.
It's not working. I don't have enough power to cure this.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
No. It's not your fault, Reyna. Sorry. I guess we don't have enough power to heal you after all.
That's okay. Don't worry about it. I gave up on it a long time ago. I've had all kinds of doctors trying to help me. I'm just happy I got a chance to talk to you.
It's Eleanor! She's in trouble!
Calm down, Ashton. What's the matter?
She's gotten a lot worse all of a sudden.
We've got to do something. I don't know how much it'll help, but I'm going to do whatever I can to help her. Get a doctor over here as soon as possible, all right?
Sure!
We've done everything we can for her. I'm afraid she doesn't have much time left.
Oh, why does my child have to suffer?
There's got to be a way. Isn't there anything else we can do?
I'm so sorry. But for the most part, we've exhausted our options.
For the most part?
Yes.
So wait a minute. That means there's at least something else left to try.
Yes, there is. But there's no chance whatsoever of it actually working.
That's fine. Just tell us. What do we have to do to save Eleanor's life?
In Expellian legends, it is said that an herb called Matorx can cure any illness. If we had some of that, then perhaps...
So this Matorx herb, we'll be able to help Eleanor if we find it?
I don't know. I've never heard of Matorx outside of the old folk tales. I couldn't even tell you if it actually exists or not.
But without that Matorx herb... Eleanor has no chance.
I'm afraid it would only be a matter of time for her, if that's the case.
Are you awake?
Ashton, where am I? What am I doing here? Why is it all dark? Is it nighttime already?
It's all right. I'm right here.
Huh? Why do you sound so weird, Ashton? It's like you're crying or something.
No. It's nothing.
Oh, I guess I'm just imagining it. Say, Ashton... Will you come to see me again?
Of course I will. Why are you even asking me something like that?
I'm glad. I had a really scary dream just now. I dreamed that you, my mother, and everyone else went away all of a sudden. I was alone and it was so dark.
It's all right, Eleanor. You are not alone. Not alone at all.
Yeah. That's funny. I'm all tired again. I guess I must be getting sleepy now that I feel better. Do you mind if I rest a little bit?
Oh, of course not. Sleep well.
Good night, Ashton.
Would you know of a place where this Maytorx might be found?
Not exactly, no. But based on what the folktales say, it can only be found on the mountain where the breath of the phoenix flows.
The mountain where the breath of the phoenix flows?
Let's go, Ashton!
Reyna?
We aren't gonna accomplish anything if we just stand here and second-guess ourselves. Let's go see if we can't find the Maytorx ourselves. What's there to lose?
Yeah, I guess you're right. Let's do it, Reyna!
This is it! I found it!
Let's see what it says. The exorcism of a monster must be carefully performed depending on the type of creature possessing the victim.
Dragons! What's it say about dragons?
To correctly exorcise a dragon, one must capture the king's tears as they fall from the sky into the holy silver chalice.
Where can we find this silver chalice?
The silver chalice sleeps in its maternal womb, embraced by calm, tranquil waters.
Waters? So what, is it in the ocean or a lake somewhere?
Could it be referring to Lake Cole, the one on northwest side of Cross?
But what about that maternal womb bit? I don't get that.
That must be referring to the mountain palace. It's right next to Lake Cole.
Those seeking the king's tears shall embark upon a treacherous path to the mountaintop and brace for any challenge. King's tears from the sky. It's talking about some kind of mountain bird, maybe.
Well, that could make the Laskus Mountains a candidate. That's west of Cross. They say it's where great big demon birds make their home.
The tears will be yours once you grasp victory from the ruler of the skies.
What next?
Return to the birthplace of the dragon monster, bring the chalice with the tears to your mouth, and recite the following incantation.
And then I'll be free, right?
With screams of agony and pain, the demonic dragon shall vanish from this world.
Creepy and Weepy will be killed?
Is there really a need to go that far?
Well, what about me? How about my feelings?
No one's forgetting that, Ashton. It's just that it seems kind of cruel.
Oh, come on!
Guess the cuter side of the argument's winning, huh?
Aw, poor guys. They don't deserve this.
What is it with you guys? Why are you using this tearjerker stuff on me?
Well, we can't help it, can we? Listen, how about we just keep you as is?
I finally figured out how to get rid of this thing. You think I'm just gonna let it go like this?
Well, in that case, let's head to the Mountain Palace and get the Silver Chalice first. Everything else is pointless unless we have that in hand. Ashton, nothing. Never mind.
It seems so wrong to have an Ashton without Creepy and Weepy.
Why are you doing this to me? I'm the victim here.
The Mountain Palace is on the northwest side of Cross. Let's go.
Thank you.
come to make a formal request, Your Majesty.
And what might that be?
We seek your royal permission to enter the Mountain Palace.
Oh, whatever for?
To exorcise the dragon from this man's body, sire, we must venture inside the Mountain Palace and obtain the Silver Chalice.
In that case, so be it. You have my official permission to enter the Mountain Palace. Beware, however, for the palace is overrun with fearsome monsters. You must exercise extreme caution beyond its doors.
A parting gift for your journey.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Say that's worth 10 out of 10. was easier than I thought.
One for us.
Whoa!
Nice work!
Quicker than I thought!
of 10.
Pretty weak.
Nice
that
work!
That was an easy win.
Say that's worth 10 out of 10.
over.
Glad everyone's safe.
Was a lot easier than I expected.
Now I'm one step closer to getting these monkeys off my back.
It would be nice if you could stop discussing Creepy and Weepy's painful deaths right in front of them.
Oh, come on! What about my pain? My sadness? Isn't any of that getting through to you?
Let's try not to pick on Ashton too much, all right? He'll have nothing to complain about soon enough.
I shouldn't have thought it was gonna be so easy.
Just some random minions.
That wasn't too bad.
You know, if you think about it, we're basically killing these monsters for our own selfish reasons, aren't we?
I guess if you look at it from the monster's point of view, we're basically coming in and messing up their lives.
What do you think, Creepy and Weepy? Do you hate us?
They said they're not sure, especially since they feel bad for the unlucky person they wound up being stuck to.
That's pretty funny. Sounds like Creepy and Weepy understand you more than anybody else.
What the? Why are we talking about this again?
Calm down, Ashton. We need to start searching for the King's Tears next.
Right! Out with the bad luck, in with the good. Let's get going.
The next order of business is finding the King's Tears. But where would that be?
There was something about climbing up to the top of a mountain in that book we read.
The only mountains around here are the Lascus Mountains. We can find them west of Cross.
I bet that's the place. Let's go check it out.
Figured out something new.
Work!
Oops! Look out!
That was easier than I thought.
It was just way too weak.
Are you sure this is the right place?
Shouldn't there be a bird or something right here? The one with the king's tears? See you again.
Ashton?
You've fallen on hard times, forced to possess a mortal. Where is the mighty dragon that I once knew?
Times have changed. Sacrifices must be made if you want to survive.
That can't be Ashton. It's creepy and weepy. They're talking.
Pathetic. How can you unleash even a fraction of your power in this puny body of yours? Not that I expected you to overcome me, even at full strength, of course.
I wonder about that. Try me.
Don't tell me that being stuck inside a mortal has made you insane already. If you insist, I won't stop you. Let's settle this once and for all.
Oh, it's these guys.
Oops,
again.
Look out!
Working together with a mortal. Of all the things in the world.
We have always been alone. It's comforting to have a companion for the first time.
I have always wished for what you now have. It's unfortunate that my feared existence is destined to be solitary. Farewell.
Come on, guys! We gotta take down that giant bird! Wait a minute! Where did the bird go? He was just here!
Do you think Zanae was somewhat jealous of Creepy and Weepy?
I think so, yes. I didn't think Zanae would shed actual tears for us.
Wait, what? I don't understand what's going on here.
Listen, Ashton, are you sure you want to exorcise Creepy and Weepy from your body?
Well, of course! That's what we came here for, right?
Well, I guess that means we're going to the Salva Mines next. We can only perform the ceremony at the dragon's birthplace. I doubt they would have been born anyplace else.
Pretty weak.
is it! We got it!
Let's get this back to Eleanor right away, Reyna.
Sure thing. You're all set, Ashton. You've got the chalice and the tears. All you have to do now is recite the incantation, and it will be done.
Yeah. I present my cursed body to the world so that it may be purified for all eternity. May my hobbled form be sanctified and cleansed of the evil with which it was stained. Creepy! Let my cursed body be born anew by the sacred holy water in my hand, in the light of the gods.
Creepy.
Weepy!
I can't do this. I know full well that I can't. But this was the only excuse I had to travel together with you. I thought that if it weren't for this, I'd have to say goodbye and go on with my life the way it was. But now that I'm stuck with Creepy and Weepy, I don't want them to leave me. Ever.
Ashton.
I let myself get too anxious. I was too nervous to bring up what we'd do if I didn't have this excuse to be with you guys. I thought that the only way for you to accept me was to force you into taking responsibility for all this.
That's just silly, Ashton. You've been important to us ever since we first met.
Thanks, everyone.
Creepy? Weepy?
So there's no reason why we can't stay good friends. All right, Ashton?
All right. Thanks for putting up with me. And Creepy and Weepy.
Oh, not at all. I'm glad to have you with us, Ashton.
We can handle this.
We can do this.
Yes!
Slash!
Slash! We're winning this one!
Here goes!
Not too sure.
That was tough. Let's go, Reyna.
Okay.
Eleanor!
Ashton.
Did you find any Matorks?
Yes, it's right here.
My goodness, you actually found some.
Please, give this to Eleanor.
Yes, right away.
Ashton, you need to calm down a little.
How am I supposed to do that, Reyna?
We've done everything we can for now. We'll just have to trust her doctor from here on. How'd it go?
It's a miracle. There's nothing left to worry about anymore.
Really?
What are you crying for, Ashton?
I'm not crying. I just have something in my eye. I'm gonna go upstairs for a bit.
Best stay by her side a little longer as well.
Whew, that turned out well.
cannot transmit or receive messages. You are out of emergency broadcast range.
No dice. I wonder if one of the points of light up there is Earth. Of course, even if I knew which one it was, it's not like I could ever go there. Hope Mom and Dad are doing all right. Seems like all I've done is given them reasons to worry about me.
Claude?